By the time we left Los Vidrios, it was so dark that the jagged silhouette of the mountains had merged into the darkness of the sky. We drove in silence for more than an hour. I felt tired. It was as though I did not want to talk because there was nothing to talk about. The traffic was minimal. Few cars passed from the opposite direction. It seemed as if we were the only people going south on the highway. I thought that was strange, and I kept on looking in the rearview mirror to see if there were other cars coming from behind, but there were none. After a while, I stopped looking for cars and began to dwell again on the prospect of our trip. Then I noticed that my headlights seemed extremely bright in contrast with the darkness all around, and I looked again in the rearview mirror. I saw a bright glare at first, then two points of light that seemed to have emerged from the ground. They were the headlights of a car on a hilltop in the distance behind us. They remained visible for a while, then they disappeared into the darkness as if they had been scooped away. After a moment, they appeared on another hilltop, and then they disappeared again. I followed their appearances and disappearances in the mirror for a long time. At one point, it occurred to me that the car was gaining on us. It was definitely closing in. The lights were bigger and brighter. I deliberately stepped on the gas pedal. I had a sensation of uneasiness. Don Juan seemed to notice my concern, or perhaps he was only noticing that I was speeding up. He looked at me at first, then he turned around and looked at the distant headlights. He asked me if there was something wrong with me. I told him that I had not seen any cars behind us for hours, and that suddenly I had noticed the lights of the car that seemed to be gaining on us all the time. He chuckled and asked me if I really thought it was a car. I told him it had to be a car, and he said my concern revealed to him that somehow I must have felt that whatever was behind us was something more than a mere car. I insisted that I thought it was just another car on the highway, or perhaps a truck. "What else can it be?" I said loudly. Don Juan's probing had put me on edge. He turned and looked straight at me, then he nodded slowly, as if measuring what he was going to say. "Those are the lights of the head of death," he said softly. "Death puts them on like a hat, and then shoots off on a gallop. Those are the lights of death on a gallop gaining on us, getting closer and closer." A chill ran up my back. After a while, I looked in the rearview mirror again, but the lights were not there anymore. I told Don Juan that the car must have stopped or turned off the road. He did not look back. He just stretched his arms and yawned. "No," he said. "Death never stops. Sometimes it turns off its lights. That's all."